Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the
backstage, and this time I'm standing here with the man who has issued an open challenge, the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Champion, Lewis Moore. Lewis Moore, tell us about this open challenge that you have issued to anybody who wants a shot at that goal.
Rick Diesel, it's like this. You see, there's a lot of people out there in the wrestling world that hates Lewis Moore, that wants to see Lewis Moore fail. They don't want to see Lewis Moore succeed. So first off, what I got to say to all you doubters and all you haters, screw you. But when we come to Pelham, North Carolina next week, right? Next week, I'm going to open up a contract, an open challenge to anybody. It doesn't even have to be on the AIWF roster. It's going to be an open challenge. It can be from the big promotion up north, World Wrestling Entertainment. It can be from down south, from Total Nonstop Action. It can be from any of these so-called promotions who think they can take this Mid-Atlantic Championship away from me. So boys, listen up. If you think you got what it takes to take on Lewis Moore and to take this away from me, I want you to be in Pelham, North Carolina next week.
Here for Leisure Time Rentals.
At Leisure Time, we have quality brand name furniture for your entire home at unbeatable prices. And as always, there's no credit check. Also, free delivery and setup are available. So the next time you need furniture, appliances, electronics, or computers, go to the company that was born right here in North Carolina. Our friendly staff is ready to approve you today. Leisure Time, get what you want at a price you can afford. Underway here on AIWF Mid-Atlantic Wrestling's former tag team partners, Jason Blade, you see right there, and Justin Flash facing off this week. Jason Blade's having a lot of problems with one of the fans out here. The man who many people call the greatest fan in Pelham. And he's all over Jason Blade right now. But Justin Flash has really been doing a lot to prove himself. It's his return to the AIWF, facing off with the likes of Ricky Morton and Beef, and really making a name for himself. Jason Blade with a nice headlock takeover, but a reversal from Flash brings him into the leg scissors. Oh! Jason Blade with a little surprise on Flash there. He didn't see that coming. Little headstand, fancy move. Both these men have held titles in the AIWF. Flash right now twisting the arm of Jason Blade. Nice flip. Snap bear! Oh my God, this could be it! No, Jason Blade. Oh, not two snap bears in a row! Oh my God! Three snap bears! Nobody can come back from that! But Jason Blade opts to go into a headlock. I do believe he could have pinned Justin Flash off of those series of snap bears. Now Flash working on the leg. I'll tell you, both these guys know each other so well, ladies and gentlemen. Both of them have been tag team partners. Both of them have held titles. They know every move, everything about each other. Jason Blade stomping the midsection of Justin Flash. There's that briefcase. You can see that briefcase over in the corner that Justin Flash used not too long ago on an episode a few weeks ago to defeat Beef in this same building down here in Pelham, North Carolina, at the Pelham Community Center. That's where AIWF Mid-Atlantic Wrestling is coming to you tonight from the Pelham Community Center in Pelham, North Carolina. Ladies and gentlemen, lots of things happening on AIWF Mid-Atlantic Wrestling, the hottest wrestling in the Mid-Atlantic area. And I tell you, we are one night away tomorrow night in Yanceyville, North Carolina. It all comes to a head at Capital Punishment as Jimmy Love puts the AIWF World Heavyweight title on the line against one half of the Rock and Roll Express, Ricky Morton, inside a steel cage. Nice! Nice move from Jason Blade, and followed up by a drop kick. And Justin Flash is out of the ring. Ah! There he comes! Been looking for this shot. He's had numerous shots at that heavyweight title, but every time, he's always had to deal with the old school mafia. Tomorrow night in Yanceyville, he will be facing Jimmy Love, wrapped by steel. Jason Blade down for a count, two count only. Flash kicks out, gets a foot on the rope, actually. You know, we got an action-packed show for you tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Coming up a little later on the program, Notorious. We'll be taking on Paco Loco and Corey Duncom. AIWF World Tag Team Champions facing off against AIWF Mid-Atlantic Tag Team Champions. They always put on a good show, just a flash to the eyes. The great equalizer. Oh, nice move! Flash choking Blade over the ropes. Oh, hard fit, closed fist punch right between the eyes. You don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, coming up in a week, it's the big one also, the Crazy Eight at the Mount Airy National Guard Armory. Eight wrestlers, eight cruiserweights from all over the United States. They're coming from Pennsylvania. They're coming from New Jersey. They're coming from Las Vegas. And they're all merging on Mount Airy, North Carolina, to Mount Airy National Guard Armory. For the Crazy Eight, that man right there, Justin Flash, is one of the participants in that Crazy Eight tournament. He's throwing him hard chops on Jason Blade now. Oh, Jason Blade with a nice kick to the midsection. Flash turned around with those hard chops. Flash might deal with a lot more than that in a week when he hits the Crazy Eight. Because he has to face men that he has never, ever laid eyes on in his wrestling career. Eight men vying to be the best. Who will make it to the finals is a ladder match to get that Crazy Eight title. Hey, Jim, once again, tomorrow night, lots of things happening at Bartlett Yancey High School for Capital Punishment. Cage match, Ricky Morton versus Jimmy Love for the AIWF World Heavyweight title. Notorious versus Paco, Loco, and Corey Duncom, which we have heard now may also be inside that steel cage. And then in 1 week, the Crazy Eight. Just a flash go for a fisherman suplex, but no. Ah, nice move from Jason. Blade sends Flash down hard. Ah, belly to back suplex. One, two, oh, almost three. We almost had a winner right there, ladies and gentlemen. Justin Flash loses this match 1 week away from the Crazy Eight. That could definitely put a damper on his momentum going into that tournament. He hooks it. Once again, reverse from Jason Blade. Ladies and gentlemen, one reverse after another. Oh, he got it. This could be it. One, two, three. That's it. Justin Flash has defeated Jason Blade. That'll give Flash
some injury. Diesel backstage with Cedric Alexander as we're just 1 week away from the Crazy Eight tournament. Cedric, I gotta know your feelings on it.
Crazy Eight, eight of the best cruiserweights around. Oh, it's gonna be great. It's gonna be great. See, I've scouted out the competition a little bit. I gotta say, I'm not that impressed. I'm not doubting you guys, but I'm saying, I might have your number.
There you go, Cedric Alexander, one of eight of the top cruiserweights in the entire country as they converge on Mattery, North Carolina in 1 week. You don't want to miss it.
AIWF Mid-Atlantic Wrestling fans, check out King's Hot Dog, located down at Rural Hall, North Carolina, Village Square Plaza, right off of Highway 52, exit 118. Where you can find anything from corn dogs, BLTs, chuck wagon, barbecue, and the world-famous King Dog. That's right, 14 inches, 2 pounds of meat, and with drive-through service available, if you're in a hurry, stop on by today, Village Square Plaza, Rural Hall.
Some good hot dog, fans.
Hello, wrestling fans. Rick Diesel here for Leisure Time Rentals. At Leisure Time, we have quality brand name furniture for your entire home at unbeatable prices. And as always, there's no credit check. Also, free delivery and setup are available. So the next time you need furniture, appliances, electronics, or computers, go to the company that was born right here in North Carolina. Our friendly staff is ready to approve you today. Leisure Time, get what you want at a price you can afford.
Fans, Rick Diesel here backstage, and I am with Justin Flash. And Flash, you have made it into the Crazy Eight. We're only 1 week away. You have been very, I don't want to say vocal, but I'm surprised your fingers even work after all the typing you've done on the AIWF message board at AIWFWrestling.net. But we want to hear from you what you think about the Crazy Eight.
I spoke my mind on the message board at AIWF.net, and I basically said it like it is. No one in the Crazy Eight tournament matches up to Justin Flash. Pelham thought they were going to see Cedric Alexander and Justin Flash for a Crazy Eight preview. I said no. They want to see something in the Crazy Eight, they come to the Crazy Eight. They might see me and Cedric in the finals. Who knows? Either way, I'm going to be there. I'm going to take it. The Crazy Eight is going to be the night of Flash.
Ladies and gentlemen, both teams are ready in the ring. Welcome back to AIWF Mid-Atlantic Wrestling, and this is our main event of the evening. Notorious Matt Houston, Drake Tungsten, the AIWF Mid-Atlantic Tag Team Champions, standing across the ring from the prize, the big prize in tag team wrestling. There they are, the AIWF World. Yes, I said it, and I'll say it again, World. Tag team titles recognized in eight countries, and the holders of those belts right now, Corey Duncom, Paco Loco, and they're ready for war. The bell has rung. Referee J.R. Jackson has been assigned the task of this match. These wrestlers right here, man, they put on a clinic. They put on a show. when they face each other. Oh, hard right hand from Corey Duncom on Matt Houston. Tosses it back in the ring, and Paco Loco goes to work. Nice elbow. These two teams right here have literally had a standing feud that's been going for months. Ever since Paco Loco and Corey Duncom. Whoa, nice move from Paco. Ever since Paco Loco and Corey Duncom defeated the Andersons, AAA, JD and Jackie, for those tag team titles back at Season's Beatings in Mount Airy in December. These two teams right here have just pretty much had a standing feud as Notorious has continuously chased those AIWF World Tag Team titles, and Paco and Corey have been able to keep it right just out of the reach of Matt Houston and Drake Tunston. They faced each other several times. Paco Loco with a nice arm bar. Matt Houston looking for some hair to grab, but no, decides to go to the eyes and he tags in. Drake Tunston! Paco Loco with a nice arm drag. Tunston came in and walked right into that arm drag. Highly unusual for Drake Tunston, being the veteran that he is. You know, Drake Tunston has really become quite a staple on AIWF Mid-Atlantic Television. Drake coming out of Roanoke, Virginia, has been around for a long time. Many of you may remember him from the from UNOD, a team that toured the Carolinas and Virginia for a long time. Drake made a name for himself in that tag team, but now is really standing out as a member of Notorious with Matt Houston. Don't forget now, Matt Houston's also a member of the Mid-Atlantic Outlaws with Lewis Moore, who is the NCAA tag team champions. Corey Duncom coming down hard across Drake Tunston's arm, working that arm bar now. Tunston back into the ropes. Oh, nice shoulder tackle. Notorious has certainly got their sights set on these AIWF World Tag Team titles. Being the AIWF Mid-Atlantic Champions certainly do. Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, these two will be meeting again tomorrow night, with those tag team titles once again on the line. Capital Punishment coming to you from Yanceyville, North Carolina, Bartlett Yancey High School. This is a prelude, just a little taste of what you're going to see tomorrow night. And once again, I am telling you, there is talk that they may set that cage up early for these two teams. Tunston missing an elbow, a clothesline, and Corey Duncom with a fist drop right across the forehead. It looks like Notorious cannot catch a break in this match. The younger Duncom and Paco Loco certainly working hard here in Pelham. Yes, sir. Now Paco Loco in work. Oh, it's like Drake Tunston. Looks like maybe went to the mask. Now he's throwing those hard punches to Paco Loco's forehead. In the Danville, Virginia area for AIWF Mid-Atlantic Wrestling. This crowd's getting behind Paco Loco. Ooh, hard forearm to the back. Right in that lower back, around those kidney areas from Matt Houston. And that's one thing I have to give Notorious credit for. These guys work as a team in unison. You cannot deny that. You cannot deny how hard these guys, or how well these guys work together. Matt Houston does the same thing with Lewis Moore. I honestly believe that Matt Houston, the Manaconda, was born for tag team wrestling. He fits right into this old school mafia. But I'm very interested to see what'll happen after tomorrow night in Yanceyville when the old school mafia puts it all on the line as Drake and Matt Houston are facing off against Corey and Paco. Whichever one of these teams after tonight has those tag team titles, they will be defending them in Yanceyville. And then the big one, Jimmy Love, stepping inside that steel cage. Oh my God! Jimmy Love stepping inside that steel cage with Ricky Morton of the Rock and Roll Express, another man who has a huge score to settle with the old school mafia. Springtime's right around the corner. Everybody's getting antsy. It's always this time of year when things start getting really rough in the wrestling business. Oh, nice suplex from Paco Loco, but now he needs to get over to his partner. He needs to tag in Corey Duncom. Matt Houston with the boot. Still working over that lower back of Paco Loco. Hey, don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, be sure to check out our sponsors. All our sponsors, we appreciate them so much here on AIWF Mid-Atlantic Wrestling. That's King's Hot Dogs. Now, King's Hot Dogs is located on Highway 52 North. It's right off the Rural Hall exit. You get off Rural Hall exit, and you scoot right over there to the shopping center, right there where Tractor Supply's at. King's Hot Dogs is right there, the best freaking hot dogs you will ever put in your mouth. Home of the King Dog. Go down there and try one of them King Dogs if you think you are man enough. Also, Dr. T's Tattoos and Recording Studio up on West Pine Street. That's Highway 89 in Mount Airy. Check out Dr. T. If you got a band, you need somebody to record your music, Dr. T can handle that. Flesh Tone Studios up there in Mount Airy. And Leisure Time Rentals. Leisure Time Rentals over in Mount Airy also. Right there off of Highway 89. Matter of fact, you're almost right across the street from Dr. T's. Leisure Time Rentals. If you want it, they got it. And they won't charge you an arm and a leg for it. They'll work with you. And always no credit check needed. Drake Turks is still working over the lower back of Paco Loco. J.R. Jackson getting him to back off. Give the man at least a little bit of breathing room. Also, ladies and gentlemen, don't forget, check out Double DQ Radio every Sunday night on TalkShoe.com/AIWF live call-in radio show and my own. Check it out, Rick Diesel's Like It or Not. We've got some really good episodes coming up with that. And don't forget, the AIWF live stream channel running 24/7 right there on AIWFWrestling.net. You can watch matches and promos and videos from all over the world, from all the AIWF promotions, 8 countries, 40. AIWFWrestling.co.uk. AIWF spreading across England like the plague. We are taking over England. Check out all the going on over in England. We now have the British AIWF UK British Heavyweight Champion crown. The AIWF British UK Ladies Champion Hell Bunny. Check her out. All the great stuff going on over in England from the AIWF. You don't want to miss it. That's AIWFWrestling.net. Or to keep up what's going on right here in your backyard, AIWFMidAtlantic.com. AIWFMidAtlantic.com. That'll keep you up to date on what's going on right here in your favorite AIWF Mid-Atlantic. Drake Tungster coming in. No tag there. Kevin Williams swearing on a stack of goats. Sorry, Paco. But there was a tag. Drake Tungster in, continuing the punishment on Paco Loco. J.R. Jackson didn't see it. He's too busy over there messing around with Corey Duncom. Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, buy all your favorite AIWF DVDs. Check out all the AIWF Mid-Atlantic shows. We got the official gimmick table set up where you can buy your favorite AIWF DVDs from all the past shows from all the way from back in the 90s. Or you can check out the gimmick table online. Just go to AIWFWrestling.net and click on the shop. And you can go get your favorite DVDs. And coming soon, even more t-shirts. Things are happening all over the AIWF from sea to shining sea all around the world. AIWFWrestling.net. Drake Tungsten now continuing to work over Paco Loco. Paco favoring that lower back. This crowd squarely behind the champions. But they're going to have to really get behind Paco Loco if he's going to catch that second win. Drake Tungsten with some hard chops, and Paco's not even reacting to him. Oh, nice move from Paco Loco as he moves out of the way. Drake Tungsten getting a little jingle bells on that second rope. Now Paco needs to get over to Corey Duncom. He's trying hard, but he can't hardly move. Paco having trouble even rolling over. Drake's almost to Matt Houston to get that tag. Paco finally getting some motion. He tags in Corey. Here comes Corey. Hard right hand. Hard right hand. Corey Duncom is on fire. He's in. Matt Houston into the ropes. Big clothesline. Flying lariat. Throwing the punches in on Drake Tungsten. Now Corey Duncom has got to capitalize on the fact that he is the fresh man in the ring. Paco's still in the ring working on Matt Houston. I don't know if that's a wise decision. Evidently not, because now Paco's gone and Matt Houston is attacking Corey Duncan from behind. Notorious with the double team Irish whip. Oh! I don't know. Oh my God! Double sunset flips! J.R. Jackson with the kick. One! Two, three, there's your winners, Paco Loco and Corey Duncom. Oh my God, from out of nowhere. They are still your world tag team champions going in to capital punishment tomorrow night. Matt Houston toss. Oh no, it hit the referee. Son of a God almighty. Drake Tungsten, that SOB has hit the referee. What are they doing? Oh, Jesus. Corey Duncom down across that belt. He may be injured. He may be injured. 24 hours from their match at capital punishment. Oh! Oh, my God. Matt Houston attacking Corey Duncom. They're trying to injure him before capital punishment. They're trying to get an advantage when they go into Yanceyville. They may have injured this kid bad. J.R. Jackson's getting him out of the ring. He's literally taking his body to cover up Corey Duncom. That's some cocky SOBs right there.